Our cells need salt to work properly. But too much salt, that's also a problem. Our kidneys remove excess salt and put it in our urine so we can get rid of it. However, our kidneys can only process small amounts of salt. If we drank a lot of salty seawater, we'd feel sick and could even die. But animals that live in the sea cope with seawater in different ways, depending on how much salt their bodies can withstand. Some animals, such as ghost shrimps, can take in large amounts of salt and will maintain a balance similar to the water around them. They can suck water and salt through their skin by processes called osmosis and diffusion. Marine fish, on the other hand, are constantly drinking to keep their body hydrated, but not all that water goes into their bellies. Some of the seawater passes over special salt-extracting cells in their gills. The rest is swallowed down. A saltwater fish's gills and kidneys work over time to process all the salt and flush it back into the ocean. Meanwhile, seabirds such as albatrosses have special glands that absorb the salt from seawater and flush it out through their beak nostrils. Turtles remove the excess salt from the eyes, which is why they sometimes look like they are crying. And seabirds and turtles also have kidneys that remove salt in the same way that fish do. So the reason marine animals don't get sick when they drink seawater is because the species have lived in marine water for a very long time and are adapted to living in that environment. Do you want to hear a fun fact now? What would happen if you piled all the salt in the ocean on land? If you piled all the salt in the ocean on land, it would create a layer 500 feet deep across the entire land surface of the earth. Hope you enjoyed watching. Give it a thumbs up if you liked the video.